Alright. Indiana Jones, Raider, The Lost Assassin Tomb, here we go. Surprised Mario didn't, you know, Uncle Mario, he didn't go through this one. I mean, really. It's right below the V. Out of all of them, this should be like the easiest for him. Explore the Auditori family crypt. Oh, this should be interestingly annoying. I was raised Venice, 1296. I was raised in a small house by the Venetian lagoon within sight of the rough, foam-caped waves of the sea. When I was barely old enough to walk, I became a sailor, navigating the Atlantic first as an apprentice and while carrying cargo for my father's patron, Messer Marco Polo. It was a good life. Right. Oh. One day while ashore in the harbor looking for work, I fell in love. She was barely 20, but when I looked into her eyes, the whole world was reflected back, clearer and brighter than the sun. Wow, was this guy hit by the thunderbolt! After that, I still went to sea, but my heart remained on land with the girl who had become my wife and our young son. Aww. One afternoon that summer, Messer Polo called me into his study. My father was already there, besides an older man dressed in a strange hooded cape, watching us. At that moment, everything about my life changed. My father told me he was an assassin. Moving his ring, he showed me a strange marking on his finger, explaining that our family came from an ancient order that protected and defended mankind. More like a try to instill fear in mankind and promote Shiism by trying to get rid of the Sunni Seljuk Turks. He paused. Then, when I didn't speak, Messer Polo stepped forward. He told me that the stranger in the hood would teach me, and I would return. And in return, I would carry him across the Mediterranean to Spain. And so I began my apprenticeship with Dante Alighieri, one that was to destroy every bit of happiness I would have. Damn it! Why do I have to my button over the E? Ah yes, a race across time, isn't it? Damn it, why is the camera this disorienting? Man, I hate this camera. Fuck. See, why is the camera so fucking disorienting? I hate that shit. This one makes it more difficult. It's like worst camera ever. Really terrible camera. There we go. Fuck you! Alrighty, moving on. In preparation for our voyage, Messer Alighieri met with me repeatedly. At first, our meetings were about purchasing supplies, but soon they became about higher things, about life, love, honor, and justice. He taught me that society was set up in such a way as to control its members, to stop us from thinking, from seeing. Soon, I could look past all those laws and illusions. and I understood that mankind was being used by its rulers, that we the people deserved freedom. Anyway, it was then that Dante began showing me pages from a book that Messer Polo had brought back from the palace of the great Genghis Khan. The manuscript, the codex, was about our order, the assassins, whom Genghis Khan's grandson, Hulagu Khan of the Ilkhanate, destroyed their headquarters in Almut. As for our Masayaf headquarters from the original Assassin's Creed 1, the Memlukler, took care of that like in 1273 or something, after having defeated the Mongols 13 years earlier at Ain Jalut. Go Mamluks for the win. Oh lord. Another timer. Wait, what the hell is this? You're gonna send me on a wild goose chase before I even... It's over here. Oh, nothing. So I don't like being sent on wild goose chases without looting shit first. Anyway. Just activate the damn thing. Jesus Christ. Of course, it'd make it even harder for me. Terrible camera. Come on, get up. Alright, made it. Miss any crypts or anything back there? No? Good. There we go. Our planned voyage never took place. While returning to Ravenna to pick up the remainder of his belongings, Dante died. Dismayed at the loss of my mentor, I went to inform my father, Messer Polo, of the sad news. Before I could even speak, I was ushered into the study, and my father, his face white, locked the door behind me. Shocked, I listened in silence as he spoke. Dante intended to take the Codex to Spain, where it would be safe, but he was being watched. The enemy of the assassins, the Knights Templar, apparently still existed. Of course they existed. They existed at that time. The Knights Templar were wiped out, I believe, by the Pope and the King of France in 1204. As I mentioned, ironically, the last Grand Master of the Knights Templar cursed the Pope and the King of France because, even though they deserved it for being infidels, still the way that they were, you know, gotten rid of by the Pope and everything, and you know, the way it was kind of like cruel, and the way he just damned the Pope and the King of France. A year later, I think the Pope died and the King of France fell off his horse and died as well. So that was pretty, I guess, in a way you could say God did actually do that. God did see even that was an injustice, despite they were infidels. Anyway, so it's like, what, 8 years before the Knights Templar wiped out? Anyway, I recall the stories he had told me of the Templars, and it all became clear. Dante had been murdered. Well, you can't use the word he was assassinated, because he is an assassin. The Templars knew about the Codex, and they knew about us. Shaking, my father told me to take the Codex and leave for Spain at once with my wife and child. Anyway, moving on.